Hi, my name is Thebe Magugu, and welcome to the behind the scenes of my December cover shot for GQ magazine. This is an incredible honor. You know, historically, I've always sort of shied away from the camera, but I love and respect GQ so much that it's an absolute honor to be on the cover for December. I'm very excited about that collection because it's a collaboration between myself and CLD from Castle Lite. And because I'm the first designer in this line of collaborations, I wanted it to be quite special. You know, as a designer, my ethos has always been creating clothes that are aesthetic but also have a functionality to them. And I find that I feel like a lot of people will gravitate towards this collection because it has a bit of everyone in it. I think it's a bit of both. There's negatives and positives. In the beginning, it was quite overwhelming because, you know, me being in the fashion industry, our industry came to a complete halt, you know, and the industry, it was like even 2 years ago, isn't what it is now, you know. So there was a bit of a mourning process, I won't lie, because it's a lot to get used to. But now I'm almost seeing how much of a blessing it was as well, you know, because you could really take stock and sort of realize the speed in which we were all moving at, you know. So I'm also a little grateful towards what has happened. I think the best creative advice I've received is to never compromise on your aesthetic, you know, especially in the beginning. I find that because designers and creative people in general have their own aesthetic propositions, that since it's sort of new to the world, a lot of people might not understand it at first, and maybe designers and creatives see like they need to change in a way. But like, I think the most valuable thing that I was taught by my mentors and people who taught me was that eventually people will catch on. The best business advice I've received is, I think, the most obvious, that you really have to take care of your finances. I think as creatives, we're always thinking about, you know, how to do things bigger and bolder without really thinking about the actual business side of things. And finances are like one of the most important things. So just keeping an eye on that, I think, is critical to the success of any designer. You know, winning the LVMH prize was probably one of the proudest moments of my life. You know, I grew up watching a lot of the designers under LVMH and a lot of the people who were my jury members and mentors. So to have won the prize and to be able to interact with them and learn from them was just absolutely incredible. And I hope that my win sort of inspires people to also, you know, apply for the prize or just like continue doing what they're doing, because it's an insane amount of work, but it pays off in the end. Hard work does pay off. I think Thebe Magugu is curious, not only in terms of myself as an individual, but also from a business perspective. I'm always trying to find new ways of honing my craft and telling stories and sort of just gaining knowledge from South Africa's very unique history and sharing that in my clothes. African fashion is incredibly dynamic, and I find that what makes it so special is the fact that it's almost, especially with like the younger generation of designers, are sort of merging their African heritage and their sort of globalized worldview, and that comes together, I think, to form a very strong aesthetic. If I wasn't a designer, I think I would be a musician. I'm actually so jealous that I can't of musicians, because I can't sing. But I think it's you know, whether it's fashion design or music, it's still rooted in this idea of transporting people, you know. And whereas in fashion design, I'd create sort of landscapes or sort of aesthetic propositions, I think it's so incredible that musicians get to do that with sound. I think it would be two different people, but I would say one of them is Michelle Obama. I really love what she represents and the issues and causes she fights for. And then I'd also have to say Zendaya as well. I just love that she is so incredibly talented at what she does and so beautiful, but she, like Michelle, I suppose, like, also really care about critical issues. And I think that's what's amazing about fashion. You know, it can be fabulous and glamorous, but at the heart of it, I think fashion has a great capacity to care and put together resources as well. I knew I wanted to be a designer when the day we got DSTV, the first channel that came on was FTV, and like I was just hooked from day one. You know, my mother had always been sort of very fashion conscious, and my family, but like seeing the actual industry through television just convinced me that I had to do it. So my favorite piece from the CLDX Extracurricular Thebe Magugu collection is a long line parka. It's like this white parka that has doodles and scratches and black all over it, and it's one of the more graphic pieces. And yeah, it's my favorite because even it's very specific and graphic. I feel like it can be paired in quite a few ways. You can dress it up, you can dress it down, cinch it at the waist, leave it loose. It's a versatile piece, and I think that's why it's one of my favorite pieces from the collection.